वेलकम टू ग्रेड 5 इंग्लिश ग्रामर टेंसेस इन टेंसेस. नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू सी फ्यूचर कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. आई विल बी स्टेइंग हियर अंटिल संडे. लेट्स सी. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फ्यूचर कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. यू ऑल नो फॉर्म्स ऑफ वर्ब्स. For present tense, go, goes. For past tense, went. For past participle, gone. Present participle, going. Add ing with the verb. So now we are using present participle. The same present participle form is used in the future continuous tense with auxiliary will be. Come, let us see. I will be going to house. You will be going to house. We will be going to house. They will be going to house. He will be going to house. She will be going to house. It will be going to house. In the above examples, you can see the main action is in present participle. That means ing form. Form and the auxiliary is will be for all the subjects. For all the subject, present participle form and auxiliary will be is used. In future continuous tense, the form of future continuous tense is subject plus will plus be plus a verb ing. That means present participle. I will be singing in the concert tomorrow. This is a positive sentence. Then in the negative sentence, subject will plus not plus be plus verb plus ing. That means present participle. I will not be singing in the concert tomorrow. This is a negative sentence. For the question type, will plus subject plus be plus verb ing. At last, question mark. Will you be singing in the concert tomorrow? Let's see the usage of the future continuous tense to describe interrupted actions in the future. For example, when you come tomorrow, they will be playing tennis. To express action in progress at a specific time in the future. For example, at 12 o'clock tomorrow, we will be having lunch at school. To refer to actions that are happening now and expected to continue in the future. For example, unfortunately, sea level will still be rising in 20 years. To ask a question politely about the future. Will you be bringing your friend to the party tonight? To emphasize future plans and intentions. For example, he will be coming to visit us next week. To describe atmosphere in the future. When I arrive at the party, everybody will be celebrating, some will be dancing. It mentioned a future atmosphere. To express parallel actions or series of parallel actions in the future. She will be watching TV and he will be cooking dinner. The parallel action. One action is going on and another action also going there. For example, she will be watching TV and he will be cooking. Some keywords are here. What are the keywords in the future continuous tense? By this time tomorrow, by this time next week, by this month next year, at this time tomorrow, during July and August, by 3 o'clock tomorrow. These are the some keywords used in future continuous tense. Then how to use the future continuous tense? See the picture. I will be traveling in a bus by this time tomorrow. By this time Tomorrow I will be traveling in my bus. Next, my friends will be playing, but I am working here. My friends will be playing, but I am working here. This is a use of future continuous tense. So let's see some examples. For each and every subject, you are going to use will be plus verb plus ing. That means present participle form. I will be waiting for you. They will be coming. It will be playing. She will be swimming. See, the verbs are given in the bracket. We will be drinking. He will be doing. You will be taking leave. Let's see another example. Uma's family is going on a holiday, right? What they will be doing there? So what they will be doing there? See the picture. In the order of the picture, you have to arrange the sentence. Uma will be swimming. Her brother will be playing. Her brother will be climbing in the third picture. Her father will be playing music. Her mother will be catching fish. Her brother will be shooting pictures. Okay, children, I hope you all have understood this future continuous tense. Thanks for listening. Thank you.